Kansas City Chiefs will host the Buffalo Bills in the AFC Championship game on Sunday. Chris Lovett and I will give our prediction. And don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more NFL videos.
Before we talk about anything else, I think it's just going to all come down, firstly, to can Patrick Mahomes recover from his concussion he suffered against the Browns? Because, like, obviously, if he can't, then there's no chance whatsoever that Chad Henne is going to leave the Chiefs into the Super Bowl. And if he can recover, there's also just the question how ready can he be and how hesitant he might be on any given play.
Yeah, this is the worst nightmare for the NFL, really. You know, their star player in what is the biggest game of the season so far, potentially injured and not playing. And I know there's, you know, very strict protocols with concussions that you'll need to go through, you know, always evaluated by doctors. And this might be, you know, slightly controversial, but I don't think there's a way that the NFL doesn't let Mahomes play. Even if he's not 100%, you know, this is such a massive game for them. This is, you know, one of the most watched games of the year. And to have your, you know, star not playing would really hurt the brand of the NFL. And whether rightly or wrongly, I really think the NFL would do everything in their power to let him play. And for that reason, I think he probably will play.
Yeah, I mean, I hope he's going to play because that's going to be another great matchup that we have, like with Josh Allen against Patrick Mahomes, a matchup we obviously have already seen this week in week six when the Chiefs beat the Bills 26-17, where Mahomes was kind of average for his season. He only had 225 yards and two touchdowns, but a guy that really showed up in this game was Clyde Edwards-Helaire. He had 161 yards, and that's another kind of question mark for the Chiefs. Like, he was not able to play against the Browns, so it's going to be a massive boost for the Chiefs if he can suit up again against the Bills and maybe deliver a similar performance like he did in week six. Because even though, like, the Bills were surprised me of how well they kept Lamar Jackson and the Ravens running game in check, but we've seen that like a week earlier against the Colts that they have some trouble sometimes against the running game. So if the Chiefs can just rely a bit more on the running game and maybe then not give Mahomes that many passing attempts or just kind of regulate him more, that could also be maybe a road to success.
That's the blueprint that everyone talks about when beating the Chiefs. You know, you have to be able to run the ball, keep Mahomes on the sideline, you know, limit the number of possessions. And just kind of looking at the stats and what Buffalo's done so far, Their run game has pretty much been non-existent. I mean, they rushed for 96 yards against the Colts, but over half of that was Josh Allen on scramble plays. They only managed 32 yards last week against the Ravens. And I think this might be a case of just playing to your strengths, even if it means that the Chiefs' strengths. So obviously this is assuming that Mahomes plays, and if he does, we would obviously expect Kansas City to put up quite a few points. And this might just be a situation where Buffalo almost accepts their shortcomings when trying to run the ball and just says, look, we know playing the Chiefs in Arrowhead, we're probably going to need at least 30 points to win this game. So I would probably just expect them to play to their strength, you know, air it out, maybe go for it on a few, you know, fourth downs or some quite aggressive decision making. I think the Bills will really try and take it to Kansas City, obviously assuming that Mahomes plays.
Yeah, I think if Mahomes plays, it could be a regular shootout. Like, you have just two quarterbacks that have such a strong arm, they could just throw it anywhere, from anywhere up to the field, and just going to be airing it out. And obviously the big advantage I see in that is just the great connection Josh Allen and Stephon Diggs have. Like, in only one season, they managed like a great understanding to how each of them plays, and they play well together. And the Chiefs don't really have a shutdown corner, so you would probably expect the Chiefs to constantly maybe double team Stephon Diggs, which then gives other receivers the chance to shine. But that's definitely a matchup that favors the Bills, in my opinion.
Yeah, I would. I mean, we know the Chiefs' defense isn't the best, but when you've got the offense that they have, it doesn't really need to be. It's more of a kind of prevent defense. Yeah, they don't mind giving up some yards, as long as it's, you know, threes instead of sevens and so on, because being on that team, you know, you're going to put up quite a few points on offense. And yeah, just going back to Buffalo, with their run game not really you know, having any sort of success, I think we probably would expect to see more quarterback runs from Josh Allen. That's kind of been where they've been having some success, and Kansas City aren't necessarily the best team in defending the quarterback run. They do play a fair amount of zone coverage, which I guess does help with that. But yeah, I mean, it's going to really be down to whether the Buffalo front can get any pressure on Mahomes when he's in the pocket, and vice versa. I mean, if the same as we were just saying with Rodgers, if you let these two, you know, just stand there and pick you apart and throw to the weapons they have, especially the Chiefs, it's probably not going to end too well for you. But yeah, I mean, providing everyone plays and everyone's healthy, I can see this being a shootout with, you know, 50, 60 points maybe.
Yeah, I think the Bills could actually win this game. I think the Bills defense is giving them an edge compared to the Chiefs defense and to the Chiefs, because the Bills defense played great against the Ravens offense, who you would have thought is extremely explosive and would be able to put up some points. But the way the Bills defense handled the Ravens, yeah, should make them feel very confident to be able to put a lot of pressure on Mahomes and, yeah, just limit his time that he has to throw. So I think the Bills are gonna win, also because I'm still not a fan of the Chiefs defense. The way the Browns like sometimes carve them up, and Chubb and Hunt manage to run for a lot of yards, that's kind of worries me. So I think the Bills are actually gonna go to the Super Bowl, probably very tight. I could see a very tight one. Maybe this one even goes to overtime, but I think the Bills might win by like three or four points. Yeah.
Well, the number one thing that the Bills are going to have to do if they don't want that, if they don't want the repeat of, I think it was week six, where the Chiefs ran for 245 yards, would be they definitely need to stop the run, and they you know, can't let KC just run all over them again. I think they will do a better job against the run this time, but I just think Kansas has still got enough to take this one. You know, with all of the weapons they have, and the Buffalo defense hasn't been, you know, amazing by any stretch, but still good enough. But I would say, providing everyone plays and everyone's healthy, I would give the edge to Kansas City by 3 points.